get ready to go. We're glad that you're all here, so now it's time to start the show. We're not in school, but we can still pretend by making music until this ends. We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Hey there, Falcons. Guys, this week we got some fun stuff to listen to. Some composers. So, enough talking about it. Let's make some music.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Oh, geez. Sorry, first grade. I was listening to some music. I was actually listening to something we listened to a couple of weeks ago. A story, actually. Peter and the Wolf. Peter and the Wolf. Now, Peter and the Wolf is a story that has music set to it by Sergei Prokofiev. Now, he's a composer who did something pretty cool. A lot of different music can tell stories, but this is a story that is told with music. All the characters in the story about Peter and the Wolf, well, they all have some themes to go along with them. If you think about themes, you might think of other movies. You might think of movies like Star Wars. Star Wars has characters, and they all have themes. Darth Vader, he's got a theme. Luke Skywalker, he's got a theme. The Force has a theme. If you've seen Star Wars, you know what I'm talking about. If you haven't, you're probably very confused right now. So let's get back on to Peter and the Wolf, okay? Peter and the Wolf has many different characters, and the music that goes along with these characters really helps you to get an idea of what these characters are like. So let's take a listen to each of these, and let's see what we can figure out. So here is Peter's theme.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
All right, now Peter's theme obviously was played with string instruments, a string quartet, in fact. Very nice, very, didn't sound angry. Sounded pretty happy, actually. It sounded like a nice theme. So Peter seems like he's a pretty nice character. Well, there's another character in the story, too. It's his grandfather. Let's take a listen to his theme.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
A little bit different. Had the lower notes. You know why? Well, because a grandfather's voice is usually pretty deep. So it was played with an instrument called a bassoon, and a bassoon plays those really low notes. Another character in this story. Well, it's a character that it's actually in the title, Peter and the Wolf. Let's take a listen to the Wolf's theme.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Didn't sound too friendly. Sounded like he might want to stay away from this wolf. Sounds like almost like a big, bad wolf. Played with the French horn. Kind of gives that different sound to it, that different feeling that it gives you. Well, there's other animals in the story, too. It's actually, well, let's see if you can figure out what this next one is.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Thoughts? Did it remind you of an animal? Well, maybe it reminded you of a bird. And that's because, yes, it actually was a bird. It's a bird in the story, and it's played with a flute, because it kind of sounds like a bird tweeting and singing as they're flying around. Interesting. Got another character in this story as well, another animal. This is a cat. Let's take a listen.
We're making music with our falcon friends.
Almost picture that cat walking around. Does anybody have a cat? When I was young, I had a cat, and it would sort of sneak around a little bit and lay low to the ground. Well, let's just play with a clarinet to give it sort of that feel to it that might remind you of a cat. Well, there's another animal as well in this story, a duck. Let's take a listen.
We're making music with our falcon friends.
Now, this is for the duck, and you guys know what a duck says, right? Quack. But does it say it like that? Does it say quack? Or does it say it like this? Quack. More like that, right? Well, this instrument that played it, it's called an oboe. And an oboe kind of has that nasally sound to it that almost sounds like a duck. There's actually one more theme in this story, and it's for the hunters. Let's take a listen.
We're making music with our falcon friends. We're making music with our falcon friends.
Oof. They sound pretty tough. Anybody have a hunter in your family? They go hunting for deer or turkey? Spring gobbler, perhaps? I don't know. I have someone in my family who goes hunting, and this piece of music kind of reminds me of them because they got to be pretty tough when they go out. It's played with an instrument called a timpani, big kettle drum. Now, all of these themes tell us about the characters, but there's actually a story going with this. So coming up next, I'm going to actually play for you the whole story. And in the background, as you listen to the story, there's music to really add to it, to kind of make you feel like you're there. You can almost close your eyes and picture the story. Now you're gonna see the words, you're gonna see some drawings and pictures like that, but really listen for that music in the background. Because like I said, music is really neat in that it can really help to tell a story. It really helps to give you a mood. It puts you in just the right mood to understand what's going on in that story. So enjoy Peter and the Wolf.
We're making music with our falcon friends.
Now, this is a story of Peter and the Wolf. As you know, it's a musical story, and instead of seeing our characters, we'll hear them. Now, each character will be represented in the music by a certain group of notes called a theme. For instance, whenever Peter comes into the story, you'll hear a string quartet playing something like this. For the busy little bird, whose name is Sasha, we'll hear a flute way up high. Sonia, the duck, is an oboe like this. And, Ivan, the cat, is a clarinet in a very low... in a very low register. Grandpapa is an old bassoon. The hunter's guns are kettle drums. And there is also a wolf. fierce, doesn't he? Doesn't he? But little does that old wolf know what's in store for him this day. For our hero, Peter, armed to the teeth with his trusty popgun, is setting forth in the snow to capture said wolf. Oh! There seems to have been a change of plans. For Peter's grandpapa thinks that little boys like Peter should not go out to hunt the wolf. For a great hunter like Peter, who is all of 6 years old, to be carried back into the cabin and stood in a corner is very embarrassing, especially without his gun. But I think maybe it's going to be all right. Ready? Well, listen. Are you listening? That's Peter's grandpapa, and he's falling asleep. And Peter escapes out of the cabin, across the snow, and into the dark forest, his gun at the ready. Now that old wolf better look out. What do you know? Here's Sasha, the little bird we told you about. Excitable little chap, isn't he? Hello, Petey, says Sasha. What goes? Where you going, huh? Can I go, Petey? Can I, huh? Oh, boy, a gun. Loaded, too. Going hunting? Oh, that's for me. Come on, Petey, let's go. We'll show that old wolf. And they will, too. They're just the kids that can do it. Go through the snow, comrades forever. Look out! What's that shadow? The wolf! It isn't the wolf at all. It's only Sonia the duck. Hello, Sonia. Huh? What's that? Oh, no, Sonia. No, you can't join the party. You can't run and you can't fly, and that old wolf would eat you up. Oh, no, absolutely no. Oh, all right. You can come. Wait. There's something following us. Oh, it's only Ivan the cat. Oh, Ivan. Now we're all together. Peter and Sonia the duck and Sasha the little bird and Ivan the cat. Ivan, stop looking at Sasha that way. Sasha, look out! Stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it! Oh, how can you ever hunt the wolf if you try to eat each other up? Go on now, make friends. Ivan, you're a bad cat. Tell Sasha you won't do it again. There. That's better. Come down out of the tree, Sasha. Ivan's sorry. He'll be good. once more our little band of intrepid hunters sets out to find the wolf. And they find him. Peter, Sonia, behind you, look out! WOLF! Oh, that wolf is fiercer than we thought. Run, Sonia. Hide. Peter, do something. Oh, no, Peter, not that. Peter, don't just stand that way. And don't stand that way either. Oh, Sonia, what are you doing here? This is no time to be heroic. Run, Sonia. Here lies danger and the wolf. Run, Sonia. Over there, for the hollow tree. Poor Sonia. I guess she didn't run fast enough. Just a little green feather floating to the snow by the hollow tree. Goodbye, Sonia. Will this crime go unavenged? Not if Peter and Sasha can help it. Peter is making a lasso of his rope, and Sasha is looping it up over the tree. Careful now, Peter. Careful, Sasha. Take aim. Now! Oh, they've got the wolf! I think. Yes, they have. They've got him. They've roped him by the tail. Oh, pull now. Pull, pull harder. Oh, you can pull harder than that. Pull! Pull him up right off of his feet. That's it. Sasha, Sasha, don't get too close to those awful jaws. In fact, you'd better fly, Sasha. Fly! Good for you, Sasha. Keep flying. Keep ahead of the wolf. Don't fly into that tree, Sasha. Overconfidence. I tried to tell him. Oh, this is bad. This is very bad. Now, where are we? Oh, yes. Peter has got the wolf by the tail, and the wolf is trying to get Sasha. Oh, I can't look. I think I will look. Peter! Sasha! The rope is breaking! Run! Run for your lives! Oh! Fly, Sasha! Fly for help! Faster, Sasha! Faster! Sasha, you've got to get help. Oh, he'll never make it in time. Just when things are looking blackest, hark, what's this we hear? What's this we see? Just a minute, I'll look. Why, it's the hunters, Misha, Yasha, and Vladimir. That's Vladimir in the middle. And here comes little Sasha, flying as though Peter's very life depended on it. Which it does. Tell them, Sasha. Tell the hunters. W-O-L-F. Wolf. Wolf, said the hunters. To the rescue. Peter, Peter, where are you? Oh, Peter, there you are, and you're safe. and you've captured the wolf. Oh, happy day. I think I'll say that again. Oh, happy day. Oh, Peter, what a hero. You too, Ivan. Oh, what a triumph as we parade through the town. Can't you just hear all the villagers cheer? Hooray, hooray, hooray. Everybody's happy, except the wolf. But little Sasha isn't happy. He's flown back to the hollow tree, thinking of his lost playmate, Sonia. Poor Sonia. Sonia. Sonia! Oh, then you're not dead. You hid in the hollow tree. You're safe. Oh, Sonia, this is the most wonderful, wonderful day. Now Peter can go hunting whenever he likes, and we'll all live happily ever after.
We're making music with our falcon friends.
Well, we sure had fun this week, didn't we? So, until next time, grab your coat and get your hat. Leave your worries on the doorstep. Just direct your feet to the sunny side of the street. Can't you hear? Stir.